Okay, listen, it's British Boxers time, and we've got Peter McDonagh in the house with his axe, with a waterfall in the background. And you've just missed out on some really good log chopping and full body work out there, back out in the sticks. Tell us about why you like this method of training, Peter.
You know, I've been boxing, I've been in the gym since about 33 years, since I was 6 years old. Peter Fury's changed it up for me, changed my training up. Great to be in the outdoors, you know, obviously right by a waterfall. You know, everyone calls me Peter Pan, you know, a man that never grew up. Obviously this is where I come from, you know. But it's just different training, good all over body strength. And so it's good, I enjoy it here.
And of course you're in camp here for the heavyweight title fight for Kiwi Fury versus Joseph Parker. We've just seen you training with him as well. What's it like to be part of this team that's on a mission?
Yeah, but part of a great team. Obviously Peter Fury don't do losers. Mm. And you know, I've been on board with Peter for a little while now. Obviously still with MTK and in Spain. Obviously manager Daniel and all them people were helping me still. But next journey's 23rd of September in Manchester.
Yeah, and you mentioned that,
There's a man's axe.
Here we go, there's a man's axe. You mentioned, obviously, that, you know, you're fighting the 23rd of September on Huey's undercard. You said this is sort of the first time you've had a proper camp. Tell us how that's come about.
Yeah, I mean, I had a camp for Dean Byrne, obviously not as long as this, and not as intense as this, and but listen, you know, I'm not getting no younger, I'm 40 this year, and every fight now could be my last fight, so I'm training the hardest. I'm ready for getting ready for Shayne Singleton, and obviously chop him down.
Now Shayne Singleton as well, he's a fighter much the same as you. He likes to stand and have a fight as well, doesn't he? You know, this sort of training, do you think it's going to help you in that sort of a fight, or are you looking to sort of roll back the years and use? We're being heckled here as well. Yeah. Are you looking to roll back the years and use more movement and that sort of stuff?
Yeah, no, most definitely. Listen, I'm just going to stand with him, have a fight with him. You know, I made the best man win, you know, on the night.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Also, I've noticed, you know, just earlier on we were looking at your footwork and stuff. You're looking sprightly. I mean, I know you say you're nearly 40, but you're looking sharp, almost like you're having your second win sort of thing.
Listen, I'm like an old Rolls Royce. I'm like a vintage Rolls Royce. Listen, I only come out twice a year, but when I come out, everyone looks. Yeah, and, you know, I've looked after myself and, you know, I've got a great backing now behind me, and I think I've got a few big...
Joseph Fury there, grow up!
listen, I fancy I've still got a few big nights in me, so obviously September the 23rd, that's all we're focusing on, Shayne Singleton, and I guarantee you the crowd are going to get a great night.
Is this almost like, is it a final hurrah, or are you hoping it's the beginning of a chapter in sort of what could be a couple more fights towards the end of your career?
Yeah, listen, it could be an Indian summer, but listen, like I say, nearly 40 years old, but I'm not saying I'm like him, but Bernard Hopkins went on to his 50, and I feel like I'm getting better with age, and I'm not an idiot, I'm not stupid, you know, I pundit on Box Nation, I do a lot of commentary and punditing, and look, I know when it's there, it's over, you know, and that's it.
And we were speaking earlier, and of course your record doesn't do you justice, really. I mean, considering the level of opposition you've been in with at short notice, just off the top of my head, you've been in with people like Gavin, Heffron, Ski, etc. Yeah. And you've taken a lot of those fights at short notice, haven't you?
Yeah, most definitely. Look, and I don't look at the past, I look at the future. You start, say, you finish, and like I say, records are for DJs, and I am the Cinderella man. And to all them fighters out there, when they get one loss, two losses, you know, the people that give up ain't champions. The people that carry on and keep trying, they're the champions.
Yeah, man. Listen, Peter McDonagh, 23rd of September, Huey Fury, Joseph Parker, undercard. You don't want to miss it. Final word to you, man.
Yeah, look, just like to say thanks for all the support, to yourselves for coming down today, spending a day with us, and obviously coming to see us train again later. Nice one.
Cheers man. Respect. You know the score. British boxers, power.